It's going.
I'd like to call this meeting to order, October 18, Miami Township Trustees. See, we have in the quote audience Gerald Simmons, Dean Pilata, Denise Swinger, Marilyn Warren. I would entertain a motion for the adoption of the minutes of October 4.
So moved.
I'll second.
There was one little minor adjustment, you don't even have to do it, but where it says new rules for political signs.
Oh, you mean the correspondence?
Yeah. It says new rules for political signs, just for accuracy, it'd be new county rules for political signs. In the future, somebody might get confused. It was our rules. That was it.
Call the roll.
Mr. Mutcher?
Yes.
Mr. Hollister?
Yes. And we had a special meeting on October 14th to reapportion. I do not have a copy of the 14th minutes.
That's one sentence.
Shall I go grab them, or do you have?
That's over there. I mean, I put them all over there, but.
What do you mean by over there?
Over there. On your desk, or on the table.
One sentence, I think.
Yep.
October 14, special meeting. Call to order. The meeting was called to order at 9:15 a.m. by Chairperson Hollister. Trustee Mutcher and Fiscal Officer Silliman were present. A motion by Mr. Mutcher and seconded by Mr. Hollister was made to adopt Resolution 2021-38, Amendment of Permanent Appropriations. Motion carried unanimously.
That number's wrong, but I'll fix it.
Which number?
The number of the appropriation.
You mean the resolution?
Yeah, the resolution.
28, too little, right?
Yes, too small.
It says 38.
Oh, that sounds much better.
Maybe
I said. Should be. You said 21, didn't you? No.
I said 21, 38. All right.
Sorry.
I see in front of me.
Sorry, all right. I misheard you. It's all good.
There being no further business to discuss, the trustees agreed to adjourn time 9:20 a.m.
I will move to approve Resolution 2021-38.
No. It's to approve the minutes.
I will approve the minutes of October 14th.
Okay. I second that motion.
Well, it's the same thing. We had the resolution. I was approving resolution two.
No, we're approving the minutes.
We did that at the meeting, were they?
Okay. Can we call the roll on voting on the minutes?
Oh, Mr. Mutcher.
Yes.
Mr. Hollister.
Yes.
Thank you.
And remind me, this was what to transfer $250.
Yeah, it's a big one.
Or whatever it says.
No, there's no numbers or minutes.
Yeah, I think it was actually 150 for Social Security.
Okay. Anyway. I would entertain a motion to approve payment of bills in the amount of $68,683.61. From the general fund, $1,896.13. From the fire fund, $33,866.32. From the cemetery fund, $21,721.01. from EMS billing, $4,981.27. Road and Bridge, $6,218.88.
Question?
Before we talk about it.
Oh, I'll move.
I'll second.
Question? What was the 20, in the cemetery, what was the 20 some thousand?
Why is it that much?
Mm-hmm.
Because I paid on the Fillmore, 17,000.
Okay.
And change.
Yeah, all right.
That's for the cement base of the.
Yeah.
What do we call that?
Columbarium.
Okay. Any other discussion on the bills?
To the side of the, it's not a columbarium garden, it's a columbarium or something.
Oh, that's out of order.
No, that's still on the side.
Call the question.
Oh, Mr. Hollister?
Yes.
Mr. Mutcher?
Yes.
Thank you.
Rather than reading all the items of correspondence, are there any that trigger business tonight?
The second one about the stimulus program we probably should talk about under either new business or cemetery, whichever you prefer, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, we'll do another cemetery. A letter from the Riding Center to go under roads.
The mowing quote for the cemetery probably ought to be discussed.
What?
The quote for the next year's mowings for the cemetery.
Oh, okay.
Out of the bottom.
Okay. Does everyone have a copy of the agenda? Are there items that you would like to add to the agenda?
I have access to it on.
Well, no, I have more correspondence, Mr. Chairman.
Oh, excuse me.
May we go back?
Yes, let's go back to correspondence.
Yep. I wanted to read a portion of a nice card that we received. I'm going to not name the people. I just wanted to say that they write, we have a nice thank you on how quiet and beautiful Glen Forest Cemetery looked. This is during the burial. And an extra thank you to the groundskeeper, who was very kind and patient while we said our goodbye to him one last time. So thank you to, you're not the groundskeeper, but you don't want to be the groundskeeper, so that's fine. But that was nice. I'm glad you did a nice job.
But they thought you were the groundskeeper.
They did. I had another one. Well, I just wanted to refer to another one. I thought it was interesting. We received an email from a local resident whose name shall remain anonymous about Google Maps not registering this facility as being 101 East Herman. Still says 225 Corey Street on it. And I would think to myself, well, everybody knows that we're at 101 East Herman Street. And then I said, well, no, I thought everybody knew that we were at 101 East Herman Street.
Oh, damn.
It's 1001 Xenia Avenue.
Oh, that's from the template from the old one. When we did the groundbreaking before we switched numbers.
Mm-hmm. So I will have to apologize to said Where's Waldo writer.
Might help UPS because they can't find us.
Yeah, that's right.
They can't find us ever since Rob retired.
Yeah.
Amazon can. That's shocking.
Actually, that could be a problem. Is there something we could do to straighten that out?
I have spoken to 3 different drivers about it, and they said, oh, don't worry, I'll take care of it. And then I get a call from Chief Steve Kelly of Miami Township in Claremont County and says, hey, I've got a package here for you. So they're forwarding it to Claremont County when they show up and see what they can fix. So
Well, there are five Miami Townships in Ohio.
Postal Service figured it out.
Other correspondence?
No.
Do I repeat my question? Is there any other items for the agenda that the public would like to add?
Well, Colin, will you be talking about Halloween?
I will. It's on my list, I think. Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, the important things.
That's one of the things I added on after I printed it off.
Fire department report.
Fire department report. Since the last meeting of the board, there have been 42 EMS incidents. Yeah, those are going out a lot. And 8 fire incidents, only one in Bath Township this time, so. Yeah, I did that. Hiring update, we have completed background screenings for all 3 candidates for the open full-time position. None of them flunked out, so we'll be inviting all 3 for interviews. Not many felons among us, or among them. So depending on scheduling all these interviews goes, have a hiring recommendation to you by the November 15th meeting, sooner if possible. So they'll go through 3 interviews. Interviewed by people on their shift. They'll go through another one with different officers, Jason and me, and then the final interview. Mm-hmm. And then we've got this Japanese TV thing set up in the bay that they're about to climb over obstacles. Get shot at with tennis ball guns. We thought that'd be a fun.
That would be cool.
Really introduce them to the community.
I assume you're being facetious.
Yes.
Just for the record.
Not true. That's believe that job. Does violate some kind of HR rule, but I'm not sure. Apparatus maintenance update. Medic 81, the smaller the 2, is out of service. Yet again. It just come back from having its fuel leak fixed. When they were out on a call the other night, and the turbocharger apparently stopped working, and the ambulance wouldn't go above 38.5 miles per hour. That's the report I received. So the crews are very, very specific. So it's over at Village Automotive again, trying to figure out what's wrong with it this time. Two, yay.
How old is that vehicle?
The ambulance itself is 2005, but it was repowered, I think, in 2010.
Still got a lot of life left.
Well, John Moe's gonna love it. I'm awaiting a draft service contract from Atlantic Emergency Solutions for maintenance on the large trucks, both engines and tankers. Hopefully no one around here can do it. And we compared a couple of the companies, and Atlantic had the best price and most efficient service. Their plan, they're going to do the same thing they do with Cedarville, so we'll have a service technician here one day a month for routine stuff, and then obviously I'll call as we need them. But I haven't got the contract yet, so. Chief Miller speaks highly of them. And as I said, they've worked on our trucks before, and they do our annual pump testing, so they do a good job. Halloween. So Clifton's doing Halloween on Saturday the 30th with Clark County. So we'll send a crew over there for the annual Clifton thing. Community part at the shelter house. And then for Halloween here, Yellow Springs is doing it on the 31st, as we always do, or always have done. So we're going to do a drive-through walk-up Halloween blowout here at the station, similar to what we did last year, just because it was really easy last year. Just had everyone come to us. And frankly, I don't have the staffing anymore to send out 5 trucks filled with people and lots of candy. So keeping them all here works out pretty well. So we've got some smoke machines. I don't even get those from here anymore, unless you're using them. And we'll decorate, get candy, and
costumed fire.
I'm hoping that we can get Jason in his evil clown outfit again, and TJ was dressed up as something scary last year, so it worked out pretty well. And then, I mean, people will be just trick-or-treating as normal, and I don't know if any bonfires have popped up or not. They were talking about maybe hosting.
Newspaper hasn't advertised. Village hasn't advertised on Facebook.
I think they said something last village meeting that they're going to do that.
They are.
They were going to do, yeah, fires, yeah.
Yeah, they hadn't heard from anyone who usually hosts them, so, or at least that was last week, so, may have changed.
You're not planning to take walk-ups, yes?
Yeah, we'll do walk-ups and drive-throughs.
As long as you don't run over anybody, please.
Kind of fun.
You don't need to practice.
Yeah, we'll have a walk-through section and a drive-through section, so. We need a window. We should talk to Jason Funderly, the drive-through window, and we can just be walk-up too.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Could use some money. Some random activities that we've had recently, randomly. One of the crews rescued a stranded cat from the rafters of a barn on Harbison Road. Call came into Cedarville Township, and Chief Miller quickly corrected them and said, no, you're in Miami Township, and passed the call on to us. Thank you, Chief Miller. Luckily, it wasn't too high, and the cat wasn't too not thrilled about coming down.
That's good.
The funeral for TJ will never. We washed down the Grinnell Road covered bridge for Glen Helen at their request. They're having it painted, or restored to a degree and painted with special paint to keep it safe from vandals. So we need to wash off first. So it was good hose practice for our guys in the fire class.
How'd you get back there?
On hose.
Yes, pretty much. We ran hose from the little pull off. We used the tanker, one of the tankers, and went through about half the water. The whole interior, the exterior was an issue. So Glenn is very appreciative, and hopefully the bridge is being painted soon. So, Nate and Cassidy delivered fire safety talks for fire prevention week to two groups at the Open Air Village Preschool, the building on campus. Kids were excited to see everybody, so it was fun. First time he's done that in a while. Oh, and speaking of smoke machines, fire veteran TJ Freeze proposed to his girlfriend during a training exercise at the Township Garage last Saturday, or two Saturdays ago, I can't keep track. And she said yes, thank goodness. So, because it was a lot of work if she was going to say no. So congratulations to TJ and Christina. I think they're going to actually get married at the garage.
Oh, so.
That's a joke.
No, they got that cool second floor. She could stand up there and throw the bouquet out from there. It's perfect.
Oh, you mean out here?
No, out the garage.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
Our zoning inspector may take issue.
Yeah, probably. I did call again to Johnny requesting information about when we won't see our money.
Mm.
And he said, well, I better find out. Johnny's on.
Clip me in.
Is this a deal we've been doing on the side? No. selling electricity to illicit customers. It's for the deduct meter for water in the bank.
Yes.
And
yes.
We'll see a credit. I assume.
Yeah.
Credit.
Yeah, but that's not a bad idea. We could put a supercharger plug out in the back.
Yeah. Army of Teslas lined up to come in and park.
Yeah, we got a lot of Teslas in town.
We do indeed.
Yeah.
Does the village go for that?
They should, because we have some people that use it. Because they're parking space.
Yeah, of course. our vaccine mandate, all but one of the staff have now been vaccinated, and he has a medical exemption. That was great. Examined by our medical director. But everyone else, all my last holdouts, got it. So everyone was COVID vaccinated, thank goodness, until the next horrible thing comes along. And last but not least, we're trying to figure out if we can do a holiday party this year for the troops. Last year we did it via Zoom. I did not find it as fun as some people were.